Energy channelizing in the volume transmission phase hologram grating. Diffraction of an intensity uniform monochromatic plane wave by a volume hologram grating structure finds an adequate description in the coupled wave theory, Kovalnik, 1969. Consider propagation of radiation in a strong, Φ1π/2, transmission phase hologram grating, recorded symmetrically, under Bragg incidence of reconstruction radiation as shown in Figure 3. Of special importance during reconstruction of a strong volume hologram grating are the hologram areas, where function eta, Φ1, has extremums. In Figure 3 the extremum planes appear as dot and dash lines. These are the hologram planes that correspond to the values of phase modulation amplitude of diffracted radiation, Φ1 equals kπ/2, where k equals 1, 2, 3. In accordance with the concepts of the coupled wave theory, the vector of the radiation propagation in a hologram changes its direction in each extremum plane of function eta, Φ1. The geometrical dimensions of the radiation propagation channel in a hologram are clearly seen to be bounded and less than size delta pi/2, as shown on the diagram in Figure 3. Delta pi/2 is found in extremum plane of function eta, Φ1, with k equals 1, where Φ1 equals pi/2. The thickness of the hologram layer is denoted as pi/2. Thus, under Bragg incidence of a reconstructing beam at the entrance face of hologram grating, the propagation of the energy of diffracted and zero-order beams occurs along isophase hologram planes, i.e., radiation energy is channelized and the geometrical cross-section of its propagation channel is bounded by value delta pi/2. As shown by the present author's theoretical calculations, the effect of energy channelizing by strong transmission hologram gratings is exhibited also in the diffraction of reconstruction radiation with non-uniform intensity distribution, as it occurs in case of actual light beams. Besides, within the framework of the coupled wave theory, the energy channelizing effect has been shown to reveal itself at its fullest in case of angular spectrum, delta psi, of the incident monochromatic wave being much narrower than the width of the angular selectivity contour of a hologram layer of thickness pi/2, which is equivalent to the requirement of the beam diameter, or its size in the section plane of the hologram considered in Figure 3, being much greater than the thickness of the hologram layer, pi/2, where Φ1 equals pi/2. Process of radiation propagation in a strong transmission phase hologram grating, recorded symmetrically, under Bragg incidence reconstruction radiation, dot and dash lines are hologram planes that correspond to the values Φ1 equals kπ/2, where k equals 1, 2, 3, delta pi/2 is the cross-section of the channel of radiation energy propagation, pi/2 is the thickness of hologram layer with Φ1 equals pi/2. The author's experiments in 2008, reported at HoloExpo 2008 conference, confirmed the manifestation of the energy channelizing effect when reconstructing beam of radiation with non-uniform intensity distribution is used. The experiments involved PTR glass samples 9 mm thick, where hologram gratings were recorded under symmetrical incidence of interfering beams onto sample surface at a 45-degree angle. Interference planes in a hologram were situated perpendicularly to the front and rear sample surfaces, as shown in Figure 4a, b. The hologram recording conditions allowed setting the recording regime, needed to obtain a hologram grating with the required value of phase modulation amplitude. Reconstruction of symmetrically recorded hologram gratings in samples of identical thickness, equals 9 mm, weak hologram with Φ1 0.25 pi, and strong hologram with Φ1 equals 10.25 pi, b, d, a, b, radiation propagation diagram, where Φ is the incident, reconstructing, beam, S is the diffracted beam, R is the zero-order diffraction beam, C, D, radiation intensity distribution in the reconstructing beam on the entrance hologram face, solid curves, and in zero-order, dot lines, and diffracted, dash lines, beams at the hologram exit face. The value of phase modulation amplitude was in one case as low as Φ1 0.25 pi, Fig.4a, C, weak hologram, as Φ1 less than pi/2, and in another as high as Φ1 equals 10.25 pi, Fig.4b, d, strong hologram. Figure 4 presents the schematic view, a, b, of radiation propagations as well as the radiation energy distribution, c, d, on the front and rear faces of studied samples of identical thickness. The photograph in Figure 5 affixates the process of reconstruction of a strong hologram. The data are given in Figure 4b, d, 1 can clearly see the energy propagation channel, orientated perpendicularly to the front and rear sample faces, i.e., directed along the isophase surfaces of the hologram. The energy distributions in radiation beams on the hologram entrance and exit faces, Figure 4c, d, are processed experimental results. Parameters of beams on the hologram entrance face correspond to those of reconstructing beams used in the experiment, while the beam intensity distribution on the exit hologram face is calculated with a count of the hologram phase modulation. The phase modulation for each hologram was found experimentally by the devalue and the shape of the angular selectivity contour. The calculation for Bragg diffraction of Gaussian beams by periodically modulated media used the technique, published in works, Chu and Tamir, 1976. The calculated results for the beam intensity distribution on the exit hologram face are in qualitative agreement with the picture of beam diffraction, observed in the experiment. As noted, the terms weak hologram and strong hologram for a transmission volume phase hologram bear no relation to the devalue, but are defined by the value of phase modulation amplitude phi 1. The devalue for holograms in the experiment, which was attained under Bragg conditions in the two cases, is less than 50% for both the weak and the strong holograms. Despite the close values of DA, the appearance of the spatial intensity distribution for either of the two interacting beams, diffracted and zero order ones, on the hologram exit face differs markedly. As seen from the data of Figure 4a, intensity distribution of diffracted and zero-order beams on the exit face of a weak hologram 9 mm thick exhibits two peaks that are spaced apart and correspond to the diffracted beam and zero-order diffraction beam, transmitted 1. Here, the diffracted beam is appreciably broadened with respect to the incident 1 and exits the hologram strictly opposite to the incident 1, i.e., the diffracted beam energy propagates along antinodes of a hologram grating, which is schematically illustrated in Figure 4a. The zero-order diffraction beam propagates practically in the direction prescribed by ray optics. On the exit surface of a strong hologram, however, the diffracted beam and zero-order diffraction beam are spatially aligned with each other. The intensity distribution in zero-order and diffracted beams is practically no different from that in the reconstructing radiation beam. The spatial position of the beam specifies the direction of isophase surfaces, along which the radiation propagates. The conditions for running the experiment to observe the energy channelizing effect in reconstruction of a hologram grating 9 mm thick. Table 4 shows hologram grating parameters that enable the observation of the energy channelizing effect. Special notice should be given to the situation observed in the reconstruction of a strong hologram beyond Bragg angle. Figure 5b shows dependences, obtained in non-Bragg reconstruction of the strong hologram, its reconstruction results at Bragg angle having been given in Figure 4d. The deviation from Bragg angle in the case was 0.4 mrad, so, after crossing the entrance sample surface, the zero order beam propagated in the hologram both within the angular selectivity contour delta theta of the hologram, see Figure 2a, and partially outside its limits. The data in Figure 5b demonstrate a very interesting situation. The channelized radiation intensity in the direction of the isophase surfaces is zero as distinct from Bragg conditions of reconstruction, whereas another two radiation propagation channels emerge symmetrically to the right and the left with respect to the Bragg propagation channel. A. Observation of the energy channelizing effect in volume hologram grating 9 mm thick with phase modulation amplitude 10.25 pi. Recorded in PTR glass, incident beam illuminates the sample exit face at a 45-degree angle, beam diameter is 3 mm. B. Processed experimental results for reconstruction of a strong hologram at a deviation from Bragg angle by 0.4 mrad, radiation intensity distributions in the reconstructing beam on the hologram entrance surface, solid curves, in zero order, dot line, and diffracted, dash line, beams on the hologram exit face. Hologram parameters are the same as given in Fig 4d and Fig 5a. What is the possible reason behind the emergence of two radiation propagation channels? One can suggest the following general behavior of propagating beams in a volume hologram grating in non-Bragg reconstruction of the strong hologram. the reconstructing radiation beam deviated from Bragg reconstruction condition by value 0.4 mrad, that is less than the half width of the angular selectivity contour of a hologram at phi 1 equals pi/2, which is in the present experiment about delta theta 3 mrad.